Good evening to you. Thank you very much for making time for us for this edition of Channel One Weekend. My name is Edward Kabasa. I hope you had yourself a very wonderful day today. The government says that a vaccine is coming and the war on coronavirus will shift to new gears. We have those details for you. But first, let's have the highlights.
Na hakuna haja ya kuincite wa Kenya wapigane wenyewe kwa wenyewe. Unakuja unasema kwa mdomo mmoja serikali ni mbaya, alafu kwa mdomo mwingine ati tumefanya kama serikali. Kwani serikali ni ngapi? Unataka uzuri wake, kae naye. Kama unataja ubaya wake, toka uache wale wengine waendelee.
Shape up or ship out, President Kenyatta dares those within government who are unhappy to resign instead of criticizing government. Death on the roads, 11 killed in separate accidents in Gilgil and Dukamoja.
I'm happy to report the government has already made available a budget of 930 million Kenya shillings to facilitate the introduction of the vaccines in this country.
And COVID-19 vaccine, Kenya sets aside 930 million shillings to facilitate vaccination against COVID-19. Once again, welcome to this live broadcast. Lucy Mora is handling the sign language interpretation for us. You can interact with us throughout this program on Twitter at KBC Channel 1, on Facebook, KBC Channel 1 TV. My Twitter handle is at Ed Kabasa. Let's take a look at the stories we have lined up for you tonight. Uhuru Kenyatta has dared critics within government who are unhappy to resign instead of employing doublespeak to divide Kenyans. The president, who was launching several development projects within Nairobi, wondered why they were quick to take credit for government successes yet remain critical of the same government. Beatrice Gatonya Ngetich with the details.
The president spent Friday in Nairobi County, where he toured several development projects. His first stop was in Uthiru, where he launched the Uthiru Muthua Health Center. Following the launch, he addressed the crowd. The president would take a swipe at persons within government who he accused of doublespeak.
Unakuja unasema kwa mdomo moja serikali ni mbaya, alafu kwa mdomo mwingine ati tumefanya kama serikali. Kwani serikali ni ngapi? Unajua serikali ngapi Kenya hii? Ni moja ama ni mbili? Si ni moja? Kama unataka uzuri wake, kae naye. Kama unataja ubaya wake, toka uache wale wengine waendelee. Lakini uwezi kuja na mdomo moja unasema hii, mdomo mwingine unasema matusi ya wale ambao mko ndani yao.
The president daring those unhappy with the government operations to resign.
Uwezi kuja upande moja unatusi, na upande mwingine unasema angalia. Unaangalia nini umefanya? Kama mwingine, kitu ni moja, we are either together or we are apart. But you cannot come and take credit and then at the same time insult those you are together with.
It was a message he repeated while officiating the opening of Muthua Community Water Supply Project in Kabete, Kiambu County. He pointed out the government's desire is not to incite Kenyans against one another, but to unite the country.
Wenzangu, heshima sio utumwa. Tunaelewana? Kwa sababu siku moja itakuwa ni wewe unatukano. Tunaelewana? Na tukiwa hiyo ndio inchi ambayo tutajenga, na waambia kwa ukweli, tunajenga inchi ambaye itasambaratika na itakuwa inchi ya kilio. Lakini tukiwa inchi ambaye tunaheshimiana na tunakaa na tunajadiliana pamoja, hiyo inchi pia itakuwa inchi ya heshima na itakuwa inchi ambaye maendeleo inawezekana.
he would up his Nairobi tour at Kiamaiko, where he launched Kiamaiko Dispensary. It is here that he would drum up support for the Building Bridges Initiative Constitutional Amendment Bill, saying it holds the key to fast-tracking development as well as ending perennial chaos after the elections.
Kama Kenya hii tunataka amani na tuweze kuendelea pamoja. Mkenya awe ameishi Madhare, awe ameishi Isaweri Gatondo, awe ameishi Kisumu, awe ameishi Mombasa, awe ako na haki yake kama Mkenya ule wa dunia. Na hiyo ndio lengo la BBI. Kuhakikisha ya kwamba tumesawazisha wananchi wa Jamhuri.
Beatrice Getonye Ngetich, Channel 1 News.
Deputy President William Ruto has chided those criticizing his hustler political mantra, accusing them of being insensitive to the plight of the vulnerable in the society. Speaking in Kiambu County, the Deputy President maintained that the ongoing push for constitutional review has overshadowed the government's development agenda. Meanwhile, the Orange Democratic Movement has downplayed the rejection of the Constitution of Kenya Amendment Bill 2020 in Baringo, saying the verdict will not have any bearing on the fate of the bill.
Deputy President William Ruto took his charm offensive to the central region, the DP taking a swipe at those criticizing his hustler political mantra.
Wengine wanasema eti mambo ya mahasla ati ni kupiganisha watu tajiri na watu maskini. Mimi nataka niwaambie na wasikize vizuri. Hawa mahasla ni tuwasaidie hapa chini, ndio hata yule mtu wako juu awe na usalama, kwa sababu huyu wa chini ako na pesa mfukoni na ako na chakula.
Ruto continued to read mischief in the handshake, arguing that it is derailing the Jubilee Party's development agenda. The Deputy President condemning political intolerance and ethnic polarization.
Nyinyi ambao munapanga eti kulipa vijana wafanye fujo, na hamujalete bibi zenu, na mujalete watoto wenu, pia hasira ya Mungu iko juu yenu.
A section of leaders from the Ukambani region have, however, chided the Deputy President for popularizing the wheelbarrow politics, which they say limits the potential of the youth.
Sisi hatutaki wheelbarrow Ukambani. Sisi hatukusomesha watoto wetu wapatiwe wheelbarrow.
Wewe unajidanganya hapa, unasema unatetea wanyonge, watu wa bodaboda, watu wa baiskeli, watu wa mkokoteni, kina mama. Bwana Ruto, tunakujua.
Meanwhile, Orange Democratic Party has exuded confidence that the Constitution of Kenya Amendment Bill of 2020 will win the support of county assemblies. The party downplayed the defeat of the Constitution of Kenya Amendment Bill in the Baringo County Assembly.
You have not mentioned that Kisumu, Homa Bay and Siaya, three against one, have approved. So who should be worried? Those who don't want the BBI process to proceed, and not us, because we know our number. We are going to have counties approve it 3-1, just the same way it has started.
Number four.
The ODM party spoke even as a section of MCAs from Baringo defended the move to negative the BBI bill.
The speaker handled the assembly correctly.
Correct.
He even said the next meeting is Tuesday.
Yes.
Yeah. Afternoon, next right. week. Yeah. So what else do you want? Why are you saying the motion, I'm a discussion, Aikuisha?
You are saying it was not procedural, it was not proper, you should have rejected it.
Baringo County Assembly became the first county assembly to shoot down the BBI bill. For Channel One News, I'm Safin Aching Ouma.
11 people have died in two separate road accidents amid queries on adherence to the carrying capacity of public service vehicles in the wake of COVID-19 protocols. In the first accident, all the 9 passengers on board a Nissan Matatu died after the PSV collided head-on with a truck in Gilgil along the Nakuru-Nairobi Highway. In the second accident, 2 people died after a bodaboda they were riding on collided with a saloon car at Duka Moja along the Kericho-Nakuru Highway.
Traffic along the Kericho-Nakuru Highway came to a standstill following a road accident involving a motorcycle and a saloon car at Duka Moja near Brook Trading Center, as motorcycle riders demanded the erection of pumps.
Tungeomba sana kera na kura watuweke with immediate effect apa hii pumps. Tunataka tu pumps apa na pale, na tukiwekewa ingine huko karibu na iyo kwa tangi, itatusaidia sana.
Evidence of the impact visible from the wreckage of the vehicle. An accident that left two people dead while two others sustained injuries. Witnesses at the scene giving an account of what transpired resulting to the road accident.
Mi nilikuwa na park pikipiki pale. Nilikuwa natoka town. Nikipark pikipiki pale nasikia watu wamegongwa. Na huyo jamaa alikuwa anatoka town na wishi alikuwa anatoka town. Mi kustuka hivi nikaangalia nyuma ni nini inaendelea. Nikapata wao majamaa wamegongwa, watu waine wamegongwa, walikuwa watu wanabebwa wawili na watu madereva wawili.
Kericho OCPD Caleb Wesa confirmed the incident, cautioning motorists to be careful on the road.
At my appeal to other road users is that traffic laws must be complied with. It's a very unfortunate incident. And we are investigating. We shall give you the results.
In a separate incident, 9 people lost their lives in a deadly road crash along the Nairobi-Nakuru Highway. 8 people died on the spot while 1 other succumbed to injuries while undergoing treatment. Gilgil Sub-County Police Commander Joseph Oditi said the Nissan Matatu collided head-on with a truck that was attempting to overtake another vehicle. The incident sparked queries over the carrying capacity of public service vehicles as per the COVID-19 protocols. Police are urging motorists to exercise caution on the road to avert road accidents.
Yote ambaye walikuwa pamoja na driver ilikuwa ni watu 15 kwa hiyo gari, ambaye ni makosa kubwa. Sijui kama waliona ni mapema asubuhi na curfew imetolewa, wakaona saa hiyo pengine hakuna askari barabarani, wakaamua kubeba watu wengi zaidi, kwa sababu inamaanisha ilibeba watu 14 badala ya watu 8.
Let's take a look at the war on coronavirus now. The government has set aside some 930 million shillings to facilitate the inoculation of Kenyans against COVID-19. Health Chief Administrative Secretary Dr. Mercy Mwangangi says Kenya will receive 24 million doses from the COVAX facility and procure an additional 11 million doses from other mechanisms to vaccinate nearly 16 million people. Mwangangi spoke even as the country recorded some 260 new COVID-19 cases.
The government has cautioned Kenyans against misinformation in ongoing efforts to secure a COVID-19 vaccine. Health Chief Administrative Secretary Dr. Mercy Mwangangi says the government remains focused on ensuring Kenyans are vaccinated against the global pandemic.
The government has already made available a budget of 930 million Kenya shillings to facilitate the introduction of the vaccines in this country.
This commitment, the country will receive 24 million doses from the facility and will procure another additional 11 million doses from other mechanisms to vaccinate nearly 16 million people in the Kenyan population. And this vaccination is intended to take place through a period of 18 months, spread over 3 government fiscal years and not calendar years. The vaccines are expected to be a mix of AstraZeneca, Pfizer, Johnson & Johnson, and any other vaccine that will be included in the COVAX facility.
Mwangangi said the government has put in place vaccination infrastructure with central storage facilities in Nairobi for vaccines, required cold chain of up to negative 20 degrees, and some limited capacity of negative 70 degrees in major urban areas.
Infrastructure has been developed primarily for the immunization of children below the age of 5. And this is the same infrastructure that we will utilize for the COVID-19 vaccines, which for the first time place a requirement of the deployment of vaccines to the adult population on a large scale.
The government is building capacity of more than 23,000 healthcare workers, including 8,000 health volunteers in areas of vaccine administration. Meanwhile, Kenya reported some 260 new COVID-19 cases from a sample size of 5,873 in the last 24 hours. The latest figures has pushed the total number of confirmed cases to 102,613. 83 patients made full recovery both from hospital and home-based care. No fatalities were recorded in the last 24 hours. Currently, 341 patients are in hospital, out of whom 30 are in the intensive care unit. Another 1,319 are receiving treatment at home. Reporting for Channel One News, I'm Jackie Wambiru.
And with that, we take our first break. Don't go anywhere. Channel One Weekend still has so much lined up for you, including stories to do with the World Radio Day tomorrow. Well, we'll be marking the World Radio Day. The Kenya Broadcasting Corporation did organize something today, celebrating some 93 years of radio services in the country and beyond. Don't go anywhere. We still have that lined up for you.
Malaria ni ugonjwa hatari sana unaoua watu wengi hapa Kenya. Japo kuko na corona, hatari ya malaria bado iko. Mtoto huyu alikuwa na joto jingi, kutetemeka, kuumwa na viungo na uchovu. Alikimbizwa hospitali ya umma ambako sheria za COVID-19 uzingatiwa na ni salama kwa shughuli ya upimaji. Vipimo vilionyesha kuwa ana malaria, na papo hapo daktari akampa dawa za malaria na kumshauri azimalize, na ili kujikinga wawe wakilala ndani ya neti iliyotibiwa. Malaria husambazwa na mbu. Walio hatarini ni watoto wa chini ya miaka 5 na akina mama wajawazito. Kupimwa na kutibiwa ni bure katika hospitali zote za umma. Usisahau adui malaria. Zero malaria huanza na mimi. Chukua jukumu leo. Komesha malaria. Ujumbe huu umeletwa kwenu na Wizara ya Afya.
Every Saturday and Sunday, KBC rejuvenates your weekend with gospel tunes and strengthen your faith with the word. As we bring you Seventh-day Adventist Sermon, Saturdays at 10 a.m.
In the Bible, we can find answers. Answers to life's most important questions.
The Holy Mass on Sundays at 9:30 a.m.
Mwana kondoo wa Mungu aondoaye dhambi za dunia. Tazameni yeye anayetuponya magonjwa yetu yote ya mwili na ya roho.
The All Saints Cathedral at 11 a.m.
Pray that the Lord Jesus Christ may raise you to be a witness.
KBC Channel 1.
This weekend on KBC Channel 1.
I was held captive for 12 years.
Subject 2 escaped with someone in the building.
Now, humans hunt the lycans and vampires. This is a new war.
We stand and we fight.
Is more powerful than any of us.
Welcome back to the program. The Global Media Fraternity will on Saturday commemorate the World Radio Day under the theme New World, New Radio. The day will be used to highlight the services rendered by the radio medium throughout the COVID-19 crisis. Back home, the Kenya Broadcasting Corporation has marked the World Radio Day by celebrating 93 years of service.
The Kenya Broadcasting Corporation has celebrated 93 years of radio service. Established in 1928, the radio service has over the years churned out informative and entertaining content to millions of Kenyans over the decades.
That's Michael Bolton with Love is a Wonderful Thing. It's playing on The Breakfast Show 2021 here on KBC English Service.
KBC began its radio broadcast services in English and Kiswahili, but since opened its frequencies to various vernacular languages. KBC also boasts of a rich archive, which is home to content dating back to the early 90s. This machine, known as the Studa, has stood the test of time. Back in the days, it was used to record and play the audio tapes containing the various programs in the place of current mixers.
The producer or whoever needed to play the tape, they could come for the tape, which already has already been recorded and we have kept in our custody for future use. They used to come for it, then they go with it to the studios to play.
The audio tape, also known as the reel-to-reel, came in different sizes, and the producer picked the one to use based on the length of the intended program.
If it is 1 hour tape, this is the tape that they used to record on. If it is half hour, this one. Quarter hour, this one.
And for music, this machine known as the turntable was used. The radio industry has evolved over the years, with technology being at the core of operations today. Unlike in the old days, one can listen to the radio in the car, online and on mobile phones.
Radio still will be there and will still play a very pivotal role in people's life. And there are people out there, broadcasters, presenters, who are still, you know, true to the course. So it's not all lost. There are people there who can still make people listen to the radio and enjoy all type of, you know, age groups without feeling embarrassed or anything.
Kitu muhimu, somea uanahabari, alafu jaribu uperfect kabisa na ujiamini. Ukiwa mzuri, utapata nafasi. Hata kama kuna social media leo, watu wanafuata taarifa katika Twitter, Facebook, YouTube na kwengine. Bado watu wanatazama TV. Bado watu wanasikiliza radio.
Usiwahi ogopa threats zozote. Kama umekuja hapa kufanya kazi, wewe unafaa ujue mimi nafanyia mwananchi kazi. Na mwananchi ndiye amefanya ukue mahali pale.
This year, the World Radio Day will be marked under the theme New World, New Radio to highlight the services rendered by the radio medium throughout the COVID-19 crisis.
Mtaweza kufanya kazi wasanii watano.
UNESCO says the 10th edition of the World Radio Day will also be an opportunity to celebrate the resilience of radio, its evolution and constant adaptation for over a century to society's changes.
But times have changed, so we need to get innovative, we need to change how we do business. People used to consume radio in a certain manner, not anymore. They want to listen to you online, they want to be able to listen to you on their mobile phones. They want to interact with you better on social media.
People are getting more educated, people awareness is growing, and so you are talking to a person who is much aware about his immediate environment, isn't it? So it means that, you know, as a producer, as a presenter there, when you open your mouth like this, you've got to do your research.
A wise person once said that the power of radio is not that it speaks to millions, but that it speaks intimately and privately to each one of those millions. Hence, on this day, the legends who once ran the industry are calling on the upcoming generation to focus on churning out quality content to their audience. Nancy Okware, Channel One News.
Thank you very much, Nancy Okware, for that report. To the corridors of justice now, former IEBC Deputy Chief Executive Officer Wilson Shuley has denied culpability in the supply of 4,600 handheld devices during the March 2013 general election. Shuley, who was being cross-examined, shifted blame to the immediate officers tasked with procurement, arguing as a secondary officer, he was not directly involved. He is charged alongside former IEBC CEO James Oswago for the violation of procurement laws. Serafina Ruby with the details.
In a defense hearing before Senior Principal Magistrate Felix Kombo, former IEBC Deputy Commissioner Wilson Shuley denied wrongdoing in a case in which he's accused of using his office to improperly confer a benefit by approving payment of equipment contrary to procurement regulations.
I think that was supposed to do. Yes. So we didn't do anything like that. And then it also presupposes, Your Honor, that there must have been a motive. Why you would not want something to be done? And as far as I was concerned, having been instructed by the commission to do that which they was required to do, and the law obligated them to do that, yeah. There was no reason why they did not do it, and we never interfered in that particular process.
In his defense, he argued such charges should not fall on an officer with secondary duties or an administrative role. The court is set to issue directions on the 1st of March in a 213 million shillings graft case involving former Nairobi Governor Evans Kidero and others. They are also facing charges that include conspiracy to commit an offence of corruption, abuse of office, fraudulent accusation of public property, dealing with suspect property, and unlawful failure to pay tax to a public body. Finally, a former Kenya maritime employee, Cosmas Kiplagat Cherop, is seeking conservatory orders against the Director of Public Prosecutions, the CEO Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission, and the Anti-Corruption Court. He wants the court to block them from carrying out any further investigations or interrogations against him. Cherop says they are seeking to wrongfully charge, prosecute, and ultimately convict him for alleged offence of approving the award of tenders at a justice tender sum. For Channel One News, I'm Serafina Robbie.
The proposed constitution review process under the Building Bridges Initiative seeks to establish the Kenya Police Council, which will be responsible for the overall policy, control and supervision of the National Police Service. Tonight, on the constitutional review segment, our reporter Kevin Oshira puts into perspective proposed Clause 65 of the Constitution of Kenya Amendment Bill 2020.
The Constitution of Kenya Amendment Bill 2020 seeks to replace the National Police Service Commission with the Kenya Police Council. According to the bill, the newly established Kenya Police Council will be chaired by the Cabinet Secretary responsible for internal security. The Kenya Police Council will also consist of the Inspector General of the National Police Service, two senior members of the National Police Service units, as well as the Principal Secretary in the Ministry responsible for internal security. The two senior members of the National Police Service units will be appointed by the President. Policy control and supervision of the National Police Service top the list of functions given to the Kenya Police Council. For members of the National Police Service Commission, the bill says they shall continue to hold office for their unexpired term unless otherwise removed. Kevin Washira, Channel One News.
The government has kicked off a nationwide blood drive targeting to collect 500,000 blood units this year to address the shortage of blood in the country's blood bank. The start of the campaign attracted several persons interested in donating blood amid calls on Kenyans to donate blood as their way of showing love ahead of the start of the Valentine's weekend. Yusuf Farr with the details.
The campaign dubbed Valentine Weekend Drive kicked off at Uhuru Park in Nairobi. Kenyans turned up to donate blood in one of the 52 centers across the country where blood donation drives are taking place.
Wakuwe na positive attitude towards kutoa damu. Tusaidiane kama ile hulka yetu kama wa Kenya.
Najua hata mimi kuna relatives wangu wenye wanahitaji blood na kuna mtu alitusaidia. Na alisaidia kujitolea. Sasa mimi naona ni mzuri kujitolea tu.
As a way of ensuring integrity of the exercise, an app that tracks the movement of the blood from the donor to the recipient was available.
It's able to alert you when your blood has saved someone's life and also helps you do convenient scheduling of your blood donation. So you and it also pings you, it basically reminds you of when your donation is due, and it does that every 3 months, every 3 to 4 months, depending on your gender.
A similar exercise was launched in Bomet by the county government and the Kenya Red Cross.
Different units in the hospital need blood, like maternity, patients who are suffering from cancer, they also need blood. And we have that challenge when collecting blood. Due to COVID, the collection of blood has dropped drastically. That is why we have come to the members of the public today to come and urge them to donate blood.
The campaign aims to collect over 120 units of blood.
Wakati wa dakika 10 hapa Kenya, watu wanahitaji damu. So leo nimekuja kutoa damu, kuwasaidia wale wote wenye wanahitaji damu kwa vile majanga ya accidents na magonjwa mengine mengi.
The blood donors walked away with a flower and refreshments as a show of love during the Valentine's weekend. Yusuf Far, Channel One News.
The socioeconomic fortunes of communities living along the borders are set to improve following the unveiling of the Africa Borderlands Center. The center is tasked with monitoring and averting border conflict, mainly triggered by fights for scarce resources. More details in the county news briefs.
Speaking at the launch of the center in Lodwar, Turkana County, Devolution Cabinet Secretary Eugene Wamalwa hailed the initiative by the United National Development Program.
All they need is water, they need infrastructure, they need a conducive environment to bring the communities together to avoid resource-based.
Wamalwa says the center will help in addressing perennial border conflict through improved infrastructure and availability of scarce resources such as water, which is a main cause of conflict.
Innovation is one of the areas that the center will work to unearth, and the second is on policy research and analysis to inform what are actually the challenges but also the solutions that can then be integrated into national development plans, policies and strategies to make resources much closer to the people. So
elsewhere, a family in Kajiado is appealing for help in tracing their missing kin who went missing 1 month ago. Paulson Nyakwanya is said to have left his home for Kajiado on 27th December 2020 to visit an uncle but hasn't been seen since. His mother says the boy was turned away by the uncle, prompting him to board a matatu to Isinya town where he was last spotted.
Ni mtoto anasoma form 1 Moi Yesusu High School. Ako mnono na ni mweupe. Na hiyo alikuwa amevaa t-shirt ya gray na jeans ya blue. Ako miaka 15, 15 years.
They want anyone with information that may assist them trace him to report to the nearest police station. Meanwhile, contractors handling government projects have been put on notice of a delay in completion of the various projects. Public Works PS Gordon Kihalangwa, who toured the Kinagabatula Road, whose construction has been ongoing for over 3 years, warned the government will not tolerate any further delay in completion of the key projects.
Huwezi kuwa kazi ni ya milioni 48, alafu wewe unataka juu yake 28. That would definitely inaenda beyond the required variation. And I don't think there could be that kind of very big omission. 50%. That is already 50%. It's against the procurement law.
For Channel One News, I'm Jacqueline Masharia.
Valentine Itanga, where is your girlfriend?
I'm sitting at home. Don't sit at home hivo tu. Wekelea bid kwenye quick bid. Sasa hivo, bidha yako itakuwa leo. Na leo tunapeana fridge. Na kwambie inaitwa jokofu kwa Kiswahili. Mm. Unaweka chakula yako pale ndani, unaweka juice, unaweka maji, unaweka maziwa. Mm-hmm. Nenda kwenye quick bid sasa hivi, ufuate maagizo na uwekelee bid ya fridge siku ya leo. Kumbuka ni bidhaa bora kwenye bei ya nini? Twende pamoja.
Chini kwa chini ati tanga.
Jiunga na quick bid ni rahisi. Enda kwenye M-Pesa, bonyeza pay bill kisha weka business number 4032353 kwenye account, weka kodi ya bidhaa unayotaka na bid yako ya chini zaidi. Kwa mfano TV 16. Kisha weka shilingi 20 tu kama idadi yako. Weka bidi yako pia kwenye www.quickbid.co.ke. Kumbuka, bidi ya chini zaidi ya kipekee ndio ununua. Quickbid, bidhaa bora kwa bei ya chini.
Make this Valentine's memorable with KBC Channel 1. We are rewarding you for sharing your love. Simply send a picture of your best moments while watching KBC either alone or with your loved ones and stand a chance to be rewarded with a shopping voucher worth 5,000 shillings. Send your pictures to our WhatsApp number 0771-316-959 and let us put a smile on your face this Valentine's. Winners will be announced during our live shows Angaza and Backyard. KBC Channel 1, sharing love, appreciating you.
Welcome back. Let's do some business now. Masai Mara National Reserve has been voted the third best national park in the world by TripAdvisor Inc., an American online travel company. Serengeti National Park in Tanzania was voted the best national park in the world, while Kobe National Park, the oldest in India, was rated in the second position. Travelers hailed Masai Mara for its large flora and fauna, offering especially the wildebeest migration, which is touted as an eighth wonder of the world. In its Traveler's Choice list of the best national parks in the world, TripAdvisor rated parks based on a celebration of the views, mountains, lakes, trees, trails, and beaches that got travelers outside and into nature. Masai Mara was able to deliver and is top rated due to the 1.3 million wild-based in migration, which happens each year with predators in hot pursuit. This is considered one of the most extraordinary sights in nature happening at the Masai Mara in southwestern Kenya. The wildebeest migration is also the seventh wonder of the world. Top 10 rated attractions in the Mara include the Mara River, Mara Triangle, Ol Kinyei Conservancy, Olari Rock Conservancy, Mara North Conservancy, Musiara Swamp, among others. In other matters, Moriru Market will be open next month after years of delays and controversy over location of stores. The government has said the 390 million shilling market will accommodate almost 4,000 traders, among them people with disability. The government has also said more markets will be opened later this year to accommodate thousands of street vendors who have been having run-ins with city authorities.
This is the multi-story Mwariro Market located in Kariakoo suburb here in Nairobi. Construction of this market commenced in the year 2018, taking 2 years to complete. The market was meant to alleviate the suffering of city street vendors by allocating them space to conduct their business.
Kwa siku ya leo nimeona Mungu amenionekania, na hii kitu nilikuwa nafikiria sio ya ukweli, nimeona ni ya ukweli, na hii ndio kitu serikali inastahili endeleza hivyo.
Nilikuwa nimekuja kwa balloting, lakini nimepata no na nimeridhika. Najua Mungu atanifungulia mlango ingine na wakati wake ukifika nitafurahia.
However, even before the final coat of paint dried, traders were up in arms accusing officials from the Ministry of Housing and Urban Planning together with the Nairobi County, of colluding with some traders to lock them out of the facility, with the matter heading to court. However, today the government has announced the final list of traders who are expected to move in the market next month.
We are only balloting for 318, because for 41, that is the balance, it has been allocated to persons affected by the project.
The traders were given an opportunity in each criteria to count the number of yes, because we were telling them that in this category, yes will be 80, the no's will be this number.
The 389 million shillings World Bank funded Mwariro market has ample parking spaces for buyers, offloading bay for vehicles delivering goods, a borehole and an underground tank, a daycare facility for lactating mothers, and offices for county staff. Other markets that are currently under construction include City Park, Ngong, Jogo Road, among others. Once complete, the markets will accommodate over 9,000 traders. Alan Auko, Channel One Business.
Tourism in the Western Kenya region is set for a major boost after 14 counties formed an association to champion for growth tourism sector in the region. Under the body dubbed Lake Victoria Tourism Association, the counties have outlined major strategies in a blueprint to market the region as both local and international tourism destination.
The association, spearheaded by county governments, hoteliers and other stakeholders in the sector, will capitalize on the fast-growing domestic tourism to open up the region to the world. Speaking at Saiwa Swamp National Park after a tour of Mount Elgon National Park, chairman of the association, Robinson Anyal, said the association is a regional integration platform, will offer information and marketing plans for tourism stakeholders in the region. The team started with a caravan from Siaya County, with its climax in Trans Nzoia County, where they visited Kitale Museum, Saiwa Swamp National Park, especially for Sitatunga antelopes, and finally at Mount Elgon National Park, where they engaged stakeholders on several policy strategies to open up the region to the international community as a tourism destination.
Our main challenge, of which we are moving fast to fill the gap, is visibility, to be able to make our attraction sites be known to the world. Some of them are very good, but they're hidden from the local tourist, they're hidden from the international market.
Trans Nzoia County LVTA coordinator Naomi Karani said the region has great potential for tourism, but lack of information has made many great tourism energy remain untapped.
We had already taken the initiative to explore what we have, to be able to sell, to advocate and to market what Trans Nzoia has to offer, and also to come together and speak as one voice. So the formation of LVTA gives us a bigger opportunity. We have a bigger vision and we have a bigger aim.
However, Trans Nzoia County Commissioner Sam Ojwang called on the stakeholders to take advantage of government incentives in the sector to market the region.
Sports news now. AFC Leopards Elvis Rupia has bagged the Football Kenya Federation Premier League Player of the Month prize after he was awarded for his exemplary performance for the month of December. The striker beat KCB FC custodian Joseph Okoth as well as Eric Kapaito of Kariobangi Sharks to the award. Rupia began the season impressively as he netted 6 goals in just 4 matches played in the month. He scored the winner against Tusker on match day 1 before following that up with a brace against Bidco United in Leopard's second fixture. He wrapped up the month by grabbing the season's first hat-trick in a 3-0 win against Sofapaka. For his outstanding exploits, he received 50,000 shillings cash prize.
Kuperform poa ni unity yenye liko kwa kiwanja na set player ma coach pia.
I'm happy and I'm proud from him. So now, yes, I just came 3 days ago. We had three sessions training, you know. The guys are very focused, very concentrated. They made good job.
AS Vita Club of DR Congo are set to face off with the Simba SC of Tanzania tonight in the CAF Champions League Group A match at the Martyrs of Pentecost Stadium in Kinshasa. The match will be televised live on KBC Channel 1 at 10 p.m. tonight.
The Congolese Giants will return to action for the first time since they secured a 4-1 win over Young Buffaloes of Eswatini in the Champions League first round second leg game on the 6th of last month. The club is undefeated in their last two matches in the competition and they will be looking to start their Group A campaign with a victory over Simba. Meanwhile, Simba were held to a 2-2 draw by Azam in the Tanzanian Mainland Premier League match last weekend. The Tanzanian Giants have been inconsistent in this season's Champions League, but they will be looking to cause an upset by defeating 1973 African champions Vita Club. Karanja David for Channel 1 Sport.
And that's where we wind up matters tonight. We do thank you very much for joining us. You can always stay up to date with breaking news on our social media platforms, KBC Channel 1 TV on Facebook, at KBC Channel 1 on Twitter. You can also log on to www.kbc.co.ke for more news. And my name is Edward Kabasa. Our sign language interpreter has been Lucy Mora. Do stay with us because after the live broadcast, some football will be coming to you free and live. Up next is the weather forecast.
Nyeri and Eldoret tie at 13 degrees Celsius tonight, making the two areas the coldest in the country, with rainfall expected in the highlands east and west of the Rift Valley region. And the same will be experienced in the capital city, Nairobi, and its environs. A very good evening to you. My name is Yusuf Farah. Time now for your Channel 1 weather updates. And tomorrow morning, we'll be waking up to rains accompanied by sunny intervals in areas of Kisii and Narok, areas of the capital city, Nairobi. Meru and Nyeri, rather, will be having light rains, partly cloudy conditions accompanied by sunny intervals. The coastal region will have sunny intervals in the morning and the same will be experienced in areas of Garissa, Mandera, all the way to Lodwar and the Lake Turkana Basin. In the afternoon, there will be showers accompanied by thunderstorms in areas of Kisumu, Kericho, Narok and Eldoret. Areas of the coastal region continue to experience sunny intervals and the same in the northeastern region. The capital city continues to have light rains in the afternoon accompanied by sunny intervals. Intervals in Lodwar and areas bordering Kenya and South Sudan. As far as the temperatures are concerned, highs of 36 and lows of 24 in Lodwar. Garissa highs of 37, lows of 24, and the capital city highs of 24 and lows of 15. That wraps up your local weather forecast. The international weather forecast is coming up in a bit. Again, many thanks for keeping in Channel 1. Until we see each other tomorrow, same time, same place, only on Channel 1. Have yourselves a lovely night.